Ladakh, the land of high passes, is a ravishing and winsome region in India. With snow-capped peaks, clear blue skies, barren mountains, meandering rivers, Ladakh is picturesque. Jule from Leh, that means hello in Ladakh, and you'll find that everyone here is itching to say it to you. I'm filled with zeal and zest to share my Ladakh series with you all. It is not only one of the most beautiful places in India, but is a unique travel destination in the world. I'm sure you are going to love touring this place along with me through my videos. Trip to Ladakh was always in my bucket list, especially after watching it in some of the enchanting scenes of my favorite Bollywood movie, Three Idiots. We planned our 7-night trip to Ladakh in June 2021. For a hassle-free trip, you need to make sure you pack well and do not forget any of the necessities when traveling to the cold desert of Ladakh. Only Airtel and BSNL postpaid connection works over there. Due to unpredictable weather, you should be prepared to dress up in layers. Comfortable shoes are a must to enjoy the trekking experience. To avoid altitude sickness, carry medication as suggested by doctor. Reaching Ladakh has become extremely easy now with daily flights to Leh all year around. We took a flight from Delhi. I must say that the view leading to Ladakh has its own appeal. When you're about to reach Ladakh, the very first glimpse of the snow-laden heaven brings a twinkle to your eyes. Imagine the sight of magnificent mountains greeting you. That was a welcome I can never forget. And then as you are about to land in Leh, the characteristic mountains greet you with their silent white faces. When we reached Leh, the 360-degree view of the huge mountain ranges made me feel as if I was in a different world altogether. Ladakh is strategically located with Tibet in the east, Lahore and Spiti in the south, and Kashmir Valley to the west. Earlier it was a part of Jammu and Kashmir. Later in 2019, Ladakh got the status of a union territory. As it is situated on high altitudes, the best time to visit is in summer, between June and October, when the weather is quite pleasant. November invites heavy snowfall, temperature drops, and it becomes extremely cold. The land of Ladakh enjoys the significance of being located at the ancient Silk Route, which played an important role in the development of culture, religion, philosophy, trade, and commerce in the past. The people are mainly Buddhist. Festivals of Ladakh are alluring. If you're interested in experiencing any of them, then plan your trip accordingly. Going to Ladakh and not trying out its amazing scrumptious local food would be a big mistake. The influence of Tibet can also be seen on its cuisine. Amongst Ladakhi famous cuisine is momos and thukpa. Apples, walnuts and apricots are grown in fertile river areas. Leh, the capital city of Ladakh, is at a height of over 11,400 feet. It is where you will start your Ladakh experience. Due to its high geographical altitude, oxygen levels are low. Initially, you might find yourself breathing a little heavier than usual, and it is advised that you give your body time to acclimatize before setting out on any physical activity. Strolling in and out of the shops in Leh Bazaar. Here you can buy everything from pashminas to spices, miniature prayer wheels, handicraft, silk scarves to local jewelry. So this is my day 2 in Leh. At my back you can see Gurudwara Patthar Sahib. It is very pretty, the sun is shining and the weather is amazing.
Gurudwara Patthar Sahib is the most revered place where Guru Nanak Dev Ji, founder of the Sikh religion, is believed to have conquered a demon.
So I am at an amazing place today. This is our second stop for the day, the Magnetic Hill. At my back you can see the huge mountain which is the Magnetic Hill. It possesses impeccable magnetic properties. Third spot for the day, the Sangam. This is the world's highest point for river rafting. This is the place where you can see the confluence of two rivers, Indus and Zanskar. And now I'll be going for river rafting and I'm very thrilled for it. You can differentiate the rivers because of the different colors as it does not merge with each other.
So now we'll be doing the river rafting, all set for it. I hope you all are enjoying seeing the views and everything.
One of the seven Buddhist Shanti Stupas across the world, the Shanti Stupa in Leh, is an abode of peace and serenity. The purely white dome-shaped structure towers two stories high above the surrounding landscape. It commands excellent views of the scenic locale. Is a 17th century former royal palace and one of the central attractions in Leh. The 9-story dun-colored palace now houses a museum and a prayer room, while the highlight is the sweeping view of Leh and the surrounding Zanskar mountain from the rooftop. Hall of Fame is a museum constructed by the Indian Army in the memory of the brave Indian soldiers who laid down their lives defending the motherland in the Indo-Pakistan wars. It is located on the Leh Kargil Road, about 4 km from the city of Leh. The most popular monastery, Hemis Gompa, is situated around 45 km away from Leh. Hemis Monastery is known for its annual 2-day religious event, Hemis Festival. The Lamayuno Monastery, or popular as Moonland, is one of the most significant monasteries in Ladakh. Apart from being one of the largest monasteries, this Tibetan Buddhist monastery is also the oldest gompa in the region and is known as the Place of Freedom. The height of the monastery allows visitors to enjoy a panoramic view of the surrounding mountains of Ladakh.